get a little, I'm always curious about the fact that there's like ghost stories, like as a meme, like as an idea, have been, like people have been doing it for years. Like I've been, and for some reason, the same stories kind of come up. Like for some reason, there's a, I don't know why, but the Indian prototype for it is lady in a white sari with her feet turned backwards. Yeah. I don't know why, but that theme always comes up. And the only corollary I can find to that is stuff that you'd see in like basically Jungian psychology, where you say that everyone has a shadow and the projections that represents the dark side of you actually take a very similar avatar, very similar symbols. So feminine forms which are mysterious, you are not aware of whether or not they're malignant or not yet. That threat of them possibly being dangerous is something which scares the shit out of people. I don't know why. And these themes basically that kind of come up. And it's insane how it's very, very it's prototypical in its approach.
Absolutely. Yeah, it's I have to say that's been a problem with Indian horror as well, that it never evolved past those concerns, those thematic concerns, the fear of the darkness in the rural setting that makes you see the drifting sari clad woman, or the bungalow that is haunted, and like these motifs repeat unto itself. And in a lot of ways, what Indian noir is doing is taking those tropes and then giving them another dimension. For example, Bhangad operates purely on the haunted fort stereotype that's been done to death, but then it gives it all these thematic depths, these mirrored discussions about classism, the city versus rural divide, elitism, and the common man in India, the how we accept even a hellish place to be a normal place because we live there, and we become accepting of the horrid truths of the place. So you thread these complex thematic concerns through these stereotypical things, and suddenly you can make a new one. So Indian noir is experimenting in that space a lot, but it's also trying to introduce a lot of traditions that are established internationally, which absolutely need to seep into horror fiction. We can't keep making the same thing again and again. Yeah. So I just, it's my mission to create a body of work that will draw on this trend.
Yeah.
So I've written one Lovecraftian story that's quite tiny, but I want to write a bigger one. And we'll write some McKeenian and Blackwoodian stories, which are other trends that tap into the spirit folklore and rural terror and all those other genres. So, it's interesting that we have these kind of, thematic concerns. They're not necessarily bad, but they need to evolve.
Yes. Yeah, even...